All right, let's talk pork, all right? We're changing the topics here. So last year, more than 212 million pigs died around the world to disease, starvation, and their moms crushing them. This is costing pork producers billions of dollars every year. Now, as a little kid growing up in Iowa on a farm, I was like a little country boy. But I had a great experience. I got to see my grandpa most days, and I got to help deliver baby piglets. Thousands of baby piglets coming into the world. It was amazing. But that was coupled by the horrible effect of also having to watch 1,000 die. Thousands of piglets died from disease and from getting crushed, and I had to be the one to carry the buckets out of the farm. It was hard. And nobody should have to ever watch a piglet die. It's awful. But for you to truly understand what we're doing, and to truly embrace what this technology accomplishes, you're gonna have to. 1 in 9 piglets die every year because their mom crushes them, just like this one. I'm not that mean. This guy was lucky. Last year, 116 million piglets died from their moms crushing them, resulting in the loss, the waste, of over 22.5 billion pounds of pork. I'm Matthew Rota, CEO and co-founder of a company called SwineTech, and we have developed a technology that can reduce this loss by 74%. Now, back when I was trying to go into med school and be an obstetrician, my advisor told me you need to do anything and everything to diversify yourself from the rest of the students. So I said, you know what, I'm going back to the farm, I'm gonna manage a bunch of employees, do C-sections, and deal with medications, and shortly after I realized I didn't wanna be a doctor. I wanted to be an inventor, an entrepreneur. One morning I woke up, went to the farm 4 a.m., I don't know how I used to do that, and I had these piglets, they're all being born, I walked up, and to my left was one mom that laid on 8 of her babies. 8 were dead. It was awful. So I picked them up, took care of the whole process, came back and 2 hours later, and 3 more were dead. And that's when I drew the line. I knew there had to be a better way. So I did what I would advise all of you for the first bit of advice, customer discovery. If you have a problem and you think you have a good solution, talk to the users. I went to the World Pork Expo and interviewed hundreds of farmers from all over the world and found that 92% of producers are actively looking for a solution. And they're looking because everybody else has failed, to the point where nobody on the market is solving this problem. So I asked producers, what do you want to see in a product? And then delivered on exactly what they asked for. Our patent-pending technology, SmartGuard, can accurately identify when a piglet is getting crushed by assessing the wavelengths and frequencies of each and every one of their squeals. We use acoustic engineering, proprietary algorithms, and machine learning to filter and detect when that piglet's in distress. This was hard. All right, so this was like our biggest challenge. So we go into the farm, and I've got 1,000 pigs. I have to be able to identify which pig is being crushed. So what we did was I accessed my uncle, who was an acoustic engineer. He helped devise the exterior part of the shell, which helped draw sound in. We had an algorithm that was able to process and filter all of the squeals. And then we also used mesh networking so that each device could communicate to one another saying, hey, you know what? This pig's closer to me. I'm gonna take care of it. Just go back to sleep. We were able to solve the problem. The top graph represents that of a piglet in distress because it's fighting for food. I mean, it's upset. They get annoyed. It's like drama, piglet drama. They're all upset. But the bottom graph represents that of a pig who's squealing for its life. Breath squeal, that rhythmic pattern you heard, and that's what we used to detect that piglet. On average, a piglet will suffocate for 4.5 minutes, but we can catch that and solve it within 10 to 20 seconds. When we hear this sound, we communicate to a lightweight wearable placed on the mom, which will initiate impulses and vibrations that teach her to stand up and get off that baby piglet, allowing it to run free. This is our product in action. Another one that's dying, but we're saving it. So we gave her 5 seconds to get up on her own, let her mothering instincts kick in. But once they didn't, We intervened and came to the rescue. When we've tested this on farms, we found that we are accurate 74% of the time in saving that piglet's life. And we were even more excited when we found out that with our stimulus, we were not creating anything that hurt, scared, or stressed out the mom, which was our next biggest challenge, and still today is when communicating to the public. So we need to make sure that we are treating this animal with utmost respect. And we found that if we couldn't, we would actually be hurting lactation, which would make our business not viable. So we had to make sure we did this the right way, and we figured it out. Not only does our anti-crushing technology prevent crushing, it can accurately track real-time health, making us the Fitbit for pigs, right? Our swine management system provides real-time reports and provides actionable insights to help them better manage their sow's health. We can tell them when they're giving birth, if they're sick, if they're eating enough, are they milking their babies? A lot of stuff they don't have access to today. Now, this has all been made possible thanks to my two co-founders, Abraham Espinoza and John Rourke, and our 9 employees today. We currently just raised over $1 million, and now we are planning on commercializing this technology, and everything is in manufacturing. We are working with the largest pork producers around the world and are working on $1 million contracts to get this thing out into the field so we can save some piglets. If I had some advice for you, if I've learned anything in my farming and in entrepreneurship and in inventing this technology, specifically inventing this technology, is that life's gonna knock you down over and over and over again. And not everybody's gonna be there by your side to help you. Surround yourself with the right people that are. And also, success is dictated by how you get back up. Can you rise from that defeat and push forward? Perfection is the enemy of good enough. Think about that. This thing isn't perfect. I look at it and it's not good enough. But it doesn't have to be to truly make money and save lives and make an impact on the world. And that's truly what we're trying to accomplish. We thank the University of Iowa, MIT, and everybody who's helped us today. They've been there by our side. Iowa helped us start this company by just being there. We never would have started it. And then MIT rolls along. We participate in this awesome event. And next thing you know, we're getting on CNN, all these crazy networks that I never thought I would be a part of with a pig company. So when I started this, I'm like, who's gonna care about pigs, right? So I go and I pitch and I win $1,500 and then we have something to work on. So you guys being here for us makes a huge impact. And our vision is to truly feed the world. We want to enable farmers to do good. 53% of all the world's pork production is done in China, which means just over 11 billion pounds of pork goes to waste every single year. There's a lot of people going hungry, specifically in China. How can we enable farmers to feed them and to save lives? Not just piglet lives, people's lives. So we are proud to be the big data, Internet of Things, wearable technology provider for farmers. You know, you gotta get all the buzzwords in. Where we can enable farmers to feed the world and be a data supplier to companies like Bayer and Pfizer to make the world a better place. We are SwineTech, where the superhero piglets have been waiting for. Thank you.
We have just a couple minutes for questions. Does anyone have one? Yep. What up in the back?
How you have to adapt this if you were to move from a smaller scale farm to like a much larger factory farm where they're kind of crammed in and the environment's already very hectic, so the piglets would be very likely to be in distress most of the time.
Yeah. So
actually, what we did is we looked at the research, the past research over the 50 years of piglet crushing, and we found that back in the 70s, about 20% of all piglets that were raised in an open environment where the mom could run around with her babies right after they're born would die. So we looked and found that the crating system in farrowing farms was designed to increase the amount of time it takes a mom to lay down, reducing that loss to 12%. And then technical other things that brought in the market brought it to 8%, and now we can take it to 2%. We're also able to help the consumer get what they want. Consumer wants that mom to have more space again. Now that technology is where it's at today, we can do that. We are allowing sows to have more space because no longer do we need that much of a confinement to reduce this problem. So we're giving the consumer, the producer, and the mom what she wants. We are the sustainable and humane resource for the industry. We are able to reduce the amount of water and feed it takes to raise a pound of pork just because we're making it more efficient. So we're really excited about what we're doing in terms of piglet health and welfare.
We have time for one more.
In the middle. Yeah.
Just remind me quick, what's the stimuli to get that mama pig up?
So at first it's vibrations, and then we go to an impulse similar to, it's actually exact the same as a dog collar when you train a dog.
I got one of them.
Yeah. Yeah.
So.
Oh yeah, I have to wear it all the time. My engineers love it. They actually called me today and said, when are you gonna be back at the office? We need to shock you with something, and we need to give you some vibrations so you can make sure that you got it all honed in. And oh, it's funny. It's so small but yet effective, because when you're not expecting something, it catches you by surprise. We were having people at our expo booth just walking by, oh, that's awesome. So it's really cool what exactly that.
All right, thank you, Matthew, and thank you to all of our prize winners.